What is up, everybody, and welcome to part 12 of this playthrough. Walk through Elden Ring, picking it up with a new boss that I've found that's blocking the way to the Moonlight Altar, which is a location that's part of Ranni's questline, which dumps into the end of Blaidd's questline. And then after we finish up with this, it's going to be off to the Altus Plateau and Volcano Manor in the northern region. So that's the plan. Other than me trying not to get kicked in this fight right here. Or eaten. Well, not dying is always the point, but when getting eaten directly results in death, it's kind of implied. Astel, Naturalborn of the Void, guardian up to wherever it is. I swear I'm hitting the button right when I need to, but I guess it's too late by their standards. I'm dead. Yes, that's gonna be death. Oh shit. No, I survived the bite. I have no health, but I survived the bite. I survived the bite. There is hope. He's using outer space as a weapon. That did not go good. I did it dead. This again, not good. Ooh, we got meteors. Oh. Oh man, that's a cheap. He goes back to back with it. Alright. I don't think I'm gonna survive this one. Yeah, nope. Wow, cheap boss. It's okay though. I might just pull in the jellyfish. My MVP of the list, the jellyfish. I don't think it's gonna help at all, but. That bite, dude, that thing is nothing nice. I mean, he got me the first time, but I had slap full health. So I survived. Get him, jellyfish. Oh my god, starting off, okay, wow. So this fight, he just wanted to beat me. Right when we started the fight, he literally, the first time he warped away, he warped back and ate me. Like, that move is so cheap on this boss. You get good at everything else, and he can just do that at any time. And it's a move that if you're not slap full health, over 1200 HP, it's a one shot. I thought he could only do it after half HP. I only hit him twice and he did it. That's cheap. Fine, bitch. Second time. You boss! That guy was a royal a-hole. Straight up. But he's dead now. That was intense. That was intense. check out the thing that I just got. What is it? Not in this category. There it is. Six. Okay, you bring it to the finger reader in the round table hold. Another one of those types of boss that drops a soul type weapon or item. A male form starborn in the lightless void far away, once destroyed an eternal city and took away their sky. A falling star of ill omen. Yeah, I'd say that covers it. Gave me 80,000 souls or runes. Yeah, 80k. That's quite a lot. Is there a chat option that I didn't even look? Make sure. Hidden noise, checking out the cave. Yeah, the boss sucked too because it was not really suited to dual wield on it. At least for the two I had. I'd use the range of that long-reaching katana I got. Mostly sheath attacks. Top now. Sweet. Urania. Moonlight Altar. It's a pretty landscape. It's cool, those beams of light shooting up. That just happened. Glintstone Dragon Adula. He's the reason why alligators are ornery. Oh, I told a joke and got a shard of magic to my face for it. Like, in instant succession. I mean, like, right after that corny joke. It was like, oh, you got jokes. What'd you call that? It was. I mean, it was dirty. But towers down. Rolled right into that shit. Not too well at all.
Oh, Dragon 1, Joker 0.
He's real mean.
Very suited for battle. You know, him being a dragon and all.
Yep, that's how I feel about it. Back to Skyrim.
Round 2.
Thank you.
Which one? What's it say? What did it say? I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. Oh, yeah, probably.
He didn't just do a cone, he did an entire left to right coverage spray.
That was new. Ow. Damn dragons. Little weak dragons.
Jellyfish down. This dragon's a tough cookie right here, man.
He's being royally aggressive.
He's just guarding an area I gotta get to. There's already a gatekeeper, and I went through the gate. Now there's a dragon guarding the front door of the cathedral. Not being nice about it.
five times it wrong, ran right into that fire.
I swear sometimes the camera lock on this game is a little tricksy. It is what it is. Damn this dragon. Definitely loving this camera right now. He's like in my angle and I go to lock onto him and the camera just turns around instead. So you want to turn around and look behind you, right? Come on, man. starting to hate this dragon more than I hated the last guy. Fucking hey, just got done with that dude. Walk out the door and
what the fuck a look of this man. Same cool.
Try one more, and if not, I'm gonna just run past his ass. Continue on down this quest line. Wow, every single time I get the death, he pulls something new out and kills me in one shot. Oh, it's starting to piss me off. I'm just getting him way too close to give up, man. Like, he was done for. I was just waiting for his attack succession to complete, but I now was way out of the way. And then all of a sudden, he just apparates a giant greatsword in his mouth and drops down with a holy shit thrust. And then I was dead. Oh my gosh. Joy. Man, that's just too much from software, boss to boss, back to back. of Starlight Shards here. This area is particularly difficult. Ranni? Without her, like, sorcerer attire? Nope, put the ring on her that we got from the chest in Renala's room.
So, it was thee who would become my lord. Perhaps I needn't have warned thee. I am pleased, however. Thou art a fitting choice. I go now to the night sky. It is there I shall find mine order. I bid thee travel the path of the lord. And once all is done, we shall see each other once more.
What'd they do to you? Is that all that's here? Other than that annoying dragon? That's right. Teleport back here if I need to, so I'm gonna head to back to the Ranni's Rise.
See if anything's changed.
I think I found it. Ranni's questline is completed, and this leads to the end of Blaidd's questline. It's gonna be a good fight. I figured it would be. Rematch. He made me pay for this. And that one. Sorry. timing down with him. Right now he's kicking my ash. He's got some good attack moves. That's where the double it's a real rough place though, so be careful. Timing, man. He's got that slow, like, it's a fast swing with a slow hit attached to it, man. It's like super swing, flick back. Like, I'm fighting Blaidd. He's no joke. Mm-hmm. That is correct. He is a badass warrior. He is currently putting a smack down on me. I'll get him eventually, just hold. Yeah, it's like, whew. Oh, you meant the armor. I thought you were on the ass whooping. Man, that timing. Dude, he is kicking. I can't get the timing down. I'm getting crushed by it. Oh, he came back around with one too. You should. Here he comes again. Every time I go to heal, man. And that's not even his fault, that's mine. It's honestly not that hard of a fight, I'm just really doing bad. I just literally ate four potions back to back because I just kept letting him do that same thing I was telling you about with the bosses, that if you're in this range, as soon as you go to drink a potion, they do the same thing. It's four back to back to back to back. It only took like 8 tries, but I got it. Royal Greatsword. Blaidd's Armor. Blaidd's Gauntlets. Blaidd's Greaves. Oh my goodness, dude. That was like... intense, man. I just could not get that timing down. Golly, just whooping my ass. Yeah, I had to go Super Saiyan. He still was whooping my ass. I got one fucking potion left. Wasn't that on top? Ah, so you can do that move, that somersault stab down ice explosion with his sword. It's a colossal sword that weighs 20. Trying to two-hand the sword. That's the Blaidd's armor set. That does look sick. Looks better on him because he's like a wolf person, but you know. Sit back into my relaxed state.
Had to sit down and put my feet forward for that fight.
He wasn't playing around. Nope, not at all. That was exactly the fight I expected it to be. It took me longer than I thought it would to beat him. That was all on me. Resting at the fast travel. Give me some old drink. I'm gonna go check out the round table hold before I head to Altus Plateau. I'm gonna top off my drink.
Give her those. Head over here. See what's cracking back in with the blacksmith.
Well, I took you for dead, no matter if they are your arms then.
In this ash, I can smell the ancient stuff. It reminds me.
Game you're playing, the only thing I can think about on the planet you're on ain't no baby Rancor. Ain't no baby in the description of the thing I'm pretty sure you're talking about. Did you just get there? Yeah, that ain't no baby. Yeah, that ain't no baby. Avoid that thing at all costs is my advice. You're not there to sweep and clear, and you're there to get the double-bladed lightsaber. That's pretty much why you're there, and then you're out. I'm just saying that's the name of the game. So, you know, don't be like, oh, there's an enemy that's coming. There's an, like, if you can avoid them, I would do it. So drop this flail. I don't even know what kind of weapon. Oh, flail. Okay, got it. Like a ball and chain type weapon, flail. Skill is Nebula. Imbue the natural-born stars with magic to perform a sweeping strike. This attack leaves a dark cloud of stars in its wake that lingers briefly before exploding. Ash of War. Wave of Darkness. Plunge armament into the ground to release three waves of darkness. Follow up with a strong attack to swing the armament into a sweeping strike. Usable with great axes, great hammers, great spears, and colossal weapons. Let's go with that one. I was just about to say, everything on Dathomir hurts, dude. Everything on that planet is bad news, especially right now. Even though they're like, hey, you can go two places, this place and this place, but they don't continue the sentence and say, it's like, but I probably wouldn't go to this place if I were you. You probably shouldn't. But you can if you want to, because that's how we're going to roll this time. You'll be only able to go so far anyway. But yeah, for real. That's pretty much all you're there for. That's all you want to do. And the quickest route with the least resistance is the best way on that planet. It's like a test your mettle, let's see how hardcore I can do this. Alright, so that's that. We're ready to go to the lift, okay. Just here, Grand Lift of Dectus. I'm going to refill my drink, so I will BRB. got the two halves of the medallion. Let's see if something different happens now. Oh, what was that? Hoist medallion. Alright. This is me hoisting the medallion. And we're hoisting. We're medallioning. Something's happening. That's cool. Up the lift we go to the Altus Plateau. Yeah, because of that side quest, doing Ronnie's side quest and the end of Blaidd, I'm definitely overleveled for this area. Especially because I took that side trip to Khaled as well. So, you know, there's that whole thing. I also still have the Super Saiyan buff running, so that ain't fair. Make sure I didn't miss any NPCs or anything back there. It didn't really look too well while I came up to the lift. I was like, ooh. I ran off. Probably was nothing, but... see where it goes. I see a gold sea tree. Yay. still think it's funny, zombies walking around with strawberries. That'll happen.
Ah, look who we have here. How delightful to meet a familiar face, even after departing the Round Table Hold. I've been doing some learning of my own since then, actually, and will happily pass it along to you.
Cool.
Come yet to find the noble gold mask. I suppose it'd be closer to the Erd Tree. The path ahead might be perilous, but tread it I shall. Since departing the Round Table Hold, I've come to understand, in my solitude, how little it is I truly know. I'm yet to find the noble gold mask. I suppose he'll be closer to the Erd Tree. The path ahead might be perilous, but tread it I shall. Since departing the Round Table Hold, I've come to understand, in my solitude, how little it is I truly know.
Well, I guess I must buy most of the stuff from him, because he disappeared on me and I didn't have access to these, so I can get them while I have them.
Dude, have you got the Surge of Flame incantation yet, Reaper, where you basically just turn into a flamethrower and you can just hold down the button? That's right, he said BRB a minute ago, didn't he? So I am going to run across that bridge and grab the map fragment. Then I'm going to go to the Erd Tree, because that's where he said that guy might be. Ready to break. I'm going to follow this road to see the bridge and go left. Sorry, one more time, man. It's all the way at the end on the right of the road. Bonfire or grease. Actually, no, or it's a grace.
Takes me back. I was born at the foot of the Erd Tree. My mother gave me my purpose, though now everything is lost to me. I have to ascertain for myself the reason for which I live, burned and bodiless.
Service, Master. Ready to make adjustments to your garments. Your wardrobe includes the garb of the old demigods, and I'm afraid I can't make adjustments to them. My mum told me once that a royal seamstress would do them up in a jiffy. Just wait, Master. Before long, I'll be that good too. Is that a gift for my undeserving self? Thank you kindly. But what on earth could it... Amazing! I've never seen a golden needle. Not in all my life. With a spectacular royal crest to boot, are you certain that this is for me?
I can hardly believe it.
Have faith in me, Master. I'll polish my craft enough that I deserve this golden gift. I'll be the golden seamster, Bok. Now I'll be able to sew anything, even the threads of the demigods. Do you think that Mum would be pleased if she knew that I'm as good as any royal seamster now? Oh, it's still not enough. I need to learn how to sew from scratch like her. Master, may I ask you something? Would you mind if I called you Lord? I heard that you and the other tarnished seek the throne of the Elden Lord. Well, I know that you will be the one, and you would make just the manner of kind-hearted lord that I'd wish for. So please, if you would, allow me to call you Lord. You don't say. Thank you. Thank you. My lord.
Okay, it's going a little crazy with it.
Elden Lord, and please let I, Bok the Seamster, remain at your side. Going already, my lord. Please, do be safe on your journeys.
Homster. Bok. I see him crying. From time to time, I think he misses his mother. He wants someone to tell him he's beautiful. Does being born of a mother mean one behaves in such a manner?
Bok the seamster, ready to make adjustment. Going already.
Right.
Thank you.
Hey, you know what's better than fighting one tree sentinel that's super OP at one time? Two. At the same time. On a bridge. Not a bridge you can fall off, but a tight corridor bridge nonetheless. For horseback battle. And I was on my foot. Like, I tried to pull one, and I was, you know, fighting one for maybe like 7 seconds, and then the other boss bar pops up on the menu, like, oh shit, here we go. So, yeah, we might say screw that map fragment for now. Go for the L tree. No, I think that's another one. There's another one somewhere out. Those are just dual tree sentinels, higher level. Pretty sure the one that drops the armor is just like the draconic tree sentinel or something like that. Something different. I wonder if that door walled out. I didn't even pay attention to that when the fight started. Run by there and grab the fragment, but... Ooh, and I did forget about the ballistas. I got shot by his own ballista. When on Dathomir at that level, that's how I feel the whole time. Like, as soon as I land and get off the ship, like, I don't know how I'm still alive. Didn't fall wall out. Run! I just want the map fragment. Ooh, they're still chasing though. Yeah, that hit just came in pretty close. Oh, here they come, here they come, here they come.
That was close.
They were like, oh, he's at the grace. Alright, you win.
He's at the safe zone, can't touch him. Actually, did I see? Talk to some. Nope. Ooh, 2 golden seeds. I have enough to get another potion. That's a big place. Let's see now. There's the big tree right there. This way. See what's over there. Nice. Now you can leave that place and go to Kashyyyk.
It happens. It happens. Yeah, it's all part of it. Yeah, I was like, what? Geckos? I was like, the only geckos I remember seeing are the giant ones that try to eat me in a boss fight. Them things are weird too. They're like made out of roots, but they're like a gecko dragon, but they breathe fire even though they're made out of roots. But they're agile and a cheetah that can stick to a wall. Back to the road. Hello, goats and sheep and lambs or whatever you are. Head to the big tree. Surely a boss down there. No, you're too cool to sit on, in a fight, just gonna sit on the rock. Don't. Good. Just kill you right there. No worries, man. Where's that teleporter go?
Oh, dear. You might, right? Terribly sorry. That Lyria is a customer. to offer.
See where this portal goes. Up, up, and away, portal. Kind of look too creepy for me. A bunch of people in the village just sitting on a fire doing a weird ass two-step dance. I don't know. It's a little creepy. Number four. Yeah, another potion. Is that fire and death smoke? Nope, just death smoke. Death blighted. good. It's not too bad. That's not good. Yeah. Completely different monster. I'm still getting eaten alive. It's becoming a bit of a problem. Just never have enough health. Alright, one more again, or at least I'm going to try to take this guy out, and then that's going to be the it of the stream, because I got it labeled as the first two parts and knocked out what it's labeled as, so. death spitting a hole.
Let's see what we got from that.
Boost resistance and heal status and mix. Temporarily boosts all resistances and heal status effects. That's cool. That's it, that was the other one. Temporarily boost max HP.
Alright, let's see.
Guess I can take a couple more attempts at that damn dragon real quick before I call it this. That a-hole dragon, yes.
Too bad I don't have like a summon ash that's like dragon sling summon ash with, you know, dragon killing arrows. Like, yeah, that sounds good.
down goes the giant dragon. Not the giant dragon, but the dragon that kicked my ass. Damn! Did that say 200? I said 12,000 or 120,000. I'm pretty sure that just said 120,000. Yes, sir. It said 120,000 runes for that dragon right there. That dragon's a show off. What's he doing holding that many souls? Adula's Moonblade. Sorcery I got from it. It takes 32 intellect to wield. It conjures a cold magic greatsword, then delivers a sweeping blow that launches a blade-like projectile of frost. This sorcery can be cast repeatedly. Adula, a devourer of sorcerers, was bested and subsequently swore a knightly oath to her dark moon. So I kind of was right. The dragon was, it wasn't an illusionary dragon, but he was outside kind of guarding Ronnie's tower. That's crazy. Alright, well, that's a good end to this one. So that is going to be the end of part 12, which was the Moonlight Altar and the Altus Plateau beginning. Started with Astel, the Blaidd, killed that thing. Dragon kicked my ass, but we just came back, killed him. Went to the Manus, or Cathedral of Manus Celes. Finish up Ronnie's quest line, which ended up completing Blaidd's quest line. So the next step on the next part, part 13, will be Volcano Manor in Altus Plateau, which will be located right there. So we will work our way back from this area to the west over to Volcano Manor, which is where the other Elden Lord lives. Might actually try to work our way to the capital, see what that's about, but that'll be for the next part. So yeah, that's going to do it for this one. If you enjoyed the show and you like the content, please hit that like button. If you're not subscribed already, consider doing so for updates and notifications on all new content and all the good stuff. You know the deal. And yeah, as always, until the next one, thanks for watching. Later.